Before the Big Bang, there was nothing, absolutely nothing. No universe, no particles, just empty silence with no light. An infinite, yet infinitely small void.
Substitute teacher today, since your teacher is teaching the subatomic dance at her normal studio. So yeah, I'm just going to be covering some universal basics for you guys today.
These girls will be representing the universe, and little does the sub know that they take the beginning of the universe class very seriously.
Okay, girls, so what warm-up do you normally do?
We normally do the super force warm-up.
I've never really heard of that one before.
Alright, I'm gonna go get some of my papers really quick. I'll be back in just a second.
You guys get warming up on Super Force.
Oh, that's so pretty!
Wow, I'm gonna have to have you guys do this warm up more often. These are better than I thought you were.
This is the Superforce, the hot, dense ball of pure, raging energy that was the beginning of everything, the warm-up of the universe, so to speak. Inflation. The universe got bigger, faster than the speed of light. It was rumored to have taken less than a fraction of a second to have occurred, and expanded, exponentially. It occurred almost directly after the start of the Big Bang. So in this time that I have been speaking, the inflationary period of the Big Bang could have occurred 150,000 times. The inflationary period is referred to as the inflationary epoch. Particles were so hot that they hadn't cooled down enough to group up and form elements. They were spread out in such a way that there wasn't enough distance between them for light to pass, which means visibility would be similar to the interior of a dark cloud.
My students!
Right here.
Scientists today are only able to see as far back as when the light broke free of the plasma. They call the radiation the CMB, Cosmic Microwave Background Radiation, and it is still in the universe today.
What time is class at?
Hold on just a sec. We have to create time first.
Wait!
What?
cool?
No, it's not. Take us back.
Fine.
The creation of space was when the universe expanded faster than the speed of light and then continues to expand up until and past the present day. It contains empty nothingness of or matter, or highly populated areas with common elements and bodies like planets or stars.
All right. Now your teacher wants you to do the fundamental forces?
You miss me? I miss all of y'all. Hey. All y'all girls standing together like that. I can't take it.
The girls represent quarks, which are a tiny type of subatomic particle. The quarks combine together and turn into larger subatomic particles. The most stable of these groupings become neutrons or protons, which become the central mass of an atom. The process is controlled by the strong force. Matter was created in the battle between matter and antimatter. Matter barely outnumbered antimatter, and the small amount of matter that was left over was enough to create the entire universe as we see it.
Astrophysicists have uncovered a great deal of compelling evidence over the past 100 years to support the Big Bang Theory. Among this evidence is the observation that the universe is expanding. The light emitted from distant galaxies can be viewed in two different ways, red-tinted or blue-tinted. Blue means it's getting closer to us, and red means farther away. This is the stretching and shrinking of light waves. This means galaxies are getting closer or further to us, our own galaxy, the Milky Way. Expansion can be traced back to a single point, so naturally anything that expands can be traced back to a single point, this single point being the superforce, an infinitely small and dense point that the entire universe came from. Astronomers can get an idea of how hot the universe used to be by looking at very distant clouds of gas through high-powered telescopes. The light from these very faraway gas clouds takes a long time to get to us, so we can see them as they were a long time ago. These ancient clouds of gas that are so far away seem to be hotter than the younger clouds. Scientists also have found relative amounts of elements in the universe. Hydrogen is about 74% of the universe, and 26% is helium. Carbon, oxygen, and other heavier elements that are very common on Earth make up a very small percent of the matter found in the universe. So this proves the Big Bang in the sense that scientists have shown using mathematical calculations that these conditions could only have been made in a universe that began in a very hot, dense state and then quickly cooled and expanded. This is exactly what the Big Bang entails. The materials for stars were created when the Big Bang happened, hydrogen and helium. These elements, the first, were clumped together in small variations in the expansion of space. Of course, it required dark matter, which is an undefined type of matter which increases the amount of gravity for a certain amount of matter. And so this dark matter joined together with the hydrogen and helium and pulled in a large amount of gas. The gas clumped and began releasing energy as it condensed, forming molecules from atoms, which further cooled the clump and allowed for even more condensing. So basically, gravity hit its equilibrium and could not condense the gas cloud any further because the packed gas exerted a pressure against any further collapse. So then what happened is that these stars began to expand and release so much energy that they grew very bright and very large, and this is eventually how they started. There are other aspects that also play large roles in the formation of stars. Gravity pulled in all of the elements to begin with to create the central nuclei, in a sense, of the star. Other aspects of the Big Bang, like the weak nuclear force and the strong nuclear force, created the atoms and then allowed fusion to happen in order for the star to be born. Elements played a certain role in that they are both spewed out after a supernova of a very large star, and they're also created in the interior of a star.